little infernal contraption. Try again. Must try again. Pendulum anomalies nominal. 7 vibrations per hour, not practical. Encampment pressure fluttering. I just can't.
I'm...
late?
Here. Conveyors were crammed. The whole steaming city was out. I had to run the whole way. Oh, I don't see why we even have to work on the day of the...
Well, didn't I tell you? Didn't I just? That whole festival is quite frankly preposterous. Superstition and poppycock, my girl. Poppycock. There's a much finer time to be had among these gizmos, doohickeys and thingamycraptions. I'll have you know, yes, indeed, this gauge here, 27.9. Very interesting. This one here, 22.4. How unusual.
Thought you'd be finished by now.
But no. Nobody cares how many times I have to oil this goose hinge, how many times it takes to recalibrate this weasel flange. And don't get me started on all those lentil sockets. You see, girl, the Shadow Mass, despite occurring on a predictable yearly interval for 2 centuries, no less, always seems to catch this city by surprise.
Surprise? Well, I'm surprised we're still here. Never usually takes so long to reset the coils.
Precisely. The old girl's sick.
Sick? How?
She's slow. Really slow. At this rate, it'll be 7 cycles to her next setting. Twice as long as usual.
So,
if my calculations are correct, the Great Cog is slowing to a halt.
But that's...
impossible. Yes. She is historically reliable, not wavering by much more than a nanoturn in generations. The end of the machine spells the end of filtration, the end of air circulation, and the end of life here in Cogtopolis.
Really? Shadow, save us.
And yet?
What?
The readings remain normal. Pressure equalized, air ratio clean, chicken soup vending machine inedible. Nothing has changed. It's almost as if the cog is obsolete.
What? Doing nothing? Since when? How is that even possible?
There can only be one cause.
What?
Did you get the parts I told you to bring along?
Yeah, here they are.
You got that thimble wrench?
Yes.
The monkey spanner?
Yes.
The electro sock, owl sponge, salmon harness, donkey pincers?
Yes.
The biscuit iron? Mine broke again last night during my, expedition.
You were up there again? Alone. I told you not to go without me. You could fall and break your legs.
My legs are fine. Even the one with the gammy toe. Want to see what I discovered last night? Here. Look. These are the readings from my gauges way up the cavern wall. The highest ones that I've ever seen in my whole life. Off the scale.
Impossible. That would mean...
that the sun has returned to the surface. Or is returning. As yet, we have no clue about how bright it already is. Here, look. See that gauge there? The one next to the speckle plungers. The needle is bent, pointing at an estimated 250 bishops. That must have been before the gauge broke.
Unbloody believable.
Back to work, then. This could possibly explain those strange noises the giant one made earlier. I dare say it won't take long to spread the news. This city communicates almost entirely by gossip.